Okay, so in the next few classes we will be learning the integration of all problems of NCERT, which contains very good problems, of course big in number also. So let's begin with that exercises, but before beginning with the exercise I want to tell you a few things about integration. You all know the basics of integration. Now how to do the problems of integration in an easy way? So let's follow step by step method of learning or solving the problems on integration. You know, you must be in a position to do any problem as fast as possible by analyzing the technique or the method of solving, how it can be solved, of course, within a given time. So now, let's make ourselves perfect with the method of solving problems on integration. I don't want to talk much about this because you all know some of the basic formulas and some simple methods of solving integration problems. Okay. Before we start, there is an important note which I want to read it for you. Let's see what is that. If x is replaced by a linear term ax plus b, you know, x is the term which is going to change by ax plus b. For example, I can always write x as 1x plus 0. That means here a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 0. So x we have changed by the linear expression ax plus b. Then what happens? Then all the standard results hold good for ax plus b also, provided the result on the RHS is multiplied by 1 by a, where a is the coefficient of x. A is the coefficient of x in ax plus b. See here, what is a? A is the coefficient of x in ax plus b. Now let's understand what is this, because this is very important, and in fact the basic of integration begins with this. If you become familiar with what this note is telling, it's like almost 75% of integration you have learned. Okay, if x is replaced by a linear term ax plus b, so here I'll make three columns. This is the first column showing some standard result of integration, and in the second column I'm going to replace x by ax plus b, replace x by ax plus b, and then here in the third column I take one typical example to illustrate what is going on here. And these are the standard results of some basic integrations which you already know. Of course, you have to add the constant of integration C for every formula here. That's understood. Okay. Now look at this. I'm taking the first one. Integral x to the power of n dx. You know the answer is x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus C. Now look at this. Replace x by ax plus b, which is a linear expression. So it becomes integral. I will change x by ax plus b to the power of n dx. And this is equal to, now what this note says, then all the standard result hold good. This standard result will hold good even for this, provided the result on the RHS is multiplied by 1 by a. You know, this is the result on the RHS. This is LHS. X is replaced by ax plus b, the result on the RHS, this is the result on the RHS, it has to be multiplied by 1 by a. So I have to multiply, if I want to get the answer of this integration, I have to multiply by 1 by a and then write the other terms. So here x is replaced by ax plus b, so here also I have to write ax plus b to the power of n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. This becomes the answer of the integration. Notice this very well. Pay your attention. The This is the standard formula that you know. This is called as the power rule of integration. If x is replaced by a term like ax plus b, that is x is having coefficient a, here the coefficient of x is 1, and b, here there is no b term, so we can say b is 0. Supposing x is replaced by ax plus b, then it becomes integral ax plus b to the power of n dx. And what is the answer of integration of this term? It says that the right hand side is to be multiplied by 1 by a. This is the right hand side. You multiply by 1 by a, you get the answer. Now you can just look at this in order to understand it in a better way. I'll take an example. Say 2x minus 3 to the power of 5 dx. You see here, ax plus b is 2x minus 3. A is 2, b is minus 3. So x is replaced by ax plus b or ax minus b. Both will hold good. So the answer of integration is, the answer has to be multiplied by 1 by a. Here you identify what is a. A is 2 and b is minus 3. In fact, we don't want the value of b, we want the value of a alone. A only. So this becomes 1 by 2 times of 2x minus 3 to the power of 5 plus 1. See, n is 5 here. You can easily make it out. In place of n, you have 5. So in the answer part, you have to write n plus 1. So 5 plus 1, that is becoming 6 divided by n plus 1 is 6. So the answer is 2x minus 3 to the power of 6 divided by 12 plus 6. Did you understand? Yes. So similarly, I take one more example. What is the integration of 3x plus 4 to the power of minus 7 dx? This is 1 by a, so 1 by 3 into 3x plus 4, that is ax plus b, to the power of n plus 1. What is the value of n here? Minus 7. Minus 7 plus 1 is minus 6 divided by minus 6. In the next step, you can write it as 3x plus 4 to the power of minus 6 divided by minus 18. So that becomes the answer. Okay. So here, what is the importance to be given? When x is replaced by ax plus b, the answer on the RHS gets multiplied by 1 by a. That is the philosophy. I repeat once again, in any of these standard results of integration, if you replace x by a linear term ax plus b, then the right hand side of the answer of the integration gets multiplied by 1 by a. Okay? Yeah. So, that is with respect to the first formula. Now let's proceed to the second one. Now here, this is the x. You know, integral 1 by x dx is equal to log x plus c. Replace x by 1 by x. So this becomes, the problem type becomes 1 by ax plus b. The denominator, x is changed by ax plus b dx. So this says, the rule says, RHS is multiplied by 1 by a. This is RHS. Log x plus c is RHS. So multiply log x by 1 by a. So 1 by a into log of x. You have replaced x by ax plus b. This is the answer. Now take a typical example. Say integrate 1 by 7x plus 8 dx. You observe both. Numerator 1dx, 1dx. Denominator is ax plus b, 7x plus 8. So what is the value of a? A is 7, b is 8. Anyway, we don't want the value of b, so don't worry. Now the RHS is to be multiplied by 1 by a. So this is 1 by a times, that is 1 by 7 times of logarithm of 7x plus 8. Plus c, of course, you will add as the constant of integration. Okay? Now look at this example. I want to pay your attention here because this has got a small change. Integral 1 over, I say 3 minus 4x dx. Notice that a always happens to be the coefficient of x. A is always the coefficient of x. Here the coefficient of x is minus 4. A is minus 4 and B is 3. So it is as good as writing it as integral 1 by minus 4x plus 3 dx. So if you write it in this fashion, then you will easily come to know that A is minus 4. Okay, so now if you write the answer, it is 1 over minus 4 into log of 3 minus 4x plus 0. So this minus gets attached because x coefficient is minus 4. X coefficient is minus 4. Okay? Now, next one. Replace x by ax plus b. So how the problem type looks? It is 1 by root of ax plus b dx. So answer is ax plus b to the power of minus half plus 1 divided by minus half plus 1. I have used the power rule. Root of x is x to the power of half. As it goes to the numerator, it becomes x to the power of minus half. X to the power of minus half dx, which means x to the power of minus half plus 1 divided by minus half plus 1. Okay, now take a typical example. Integrate 1 over root of this expression, 6x plus 11 dx. And here you know what is missing out here. I should have multiplied this by 1 by a. Very, very important. I have now put 1 by a, which I should have put in the beginning itself. Okay, but anyway, we have put it. 1 by a into ax plus b to the power of minus half plus 1 over minus half plus 1. So according to this, it is 1 by 6 because ax plus b, a is 6, into ax plus b to the power of minus half plus 1. That is half divided by half. Or you can further write it as 2 by 6 into root of ax plus b plus c. Because you know ax plus b to the power of half is root ax plus b, and further this is 1 by 3. So the answer is 1 by 3 root ax plus b. Okay? And now for this integral sin ax plus b dx. The rule says the RHS of the answer, this is LHS, this is RHS. The RHS has to be multiplied by 1 by a. So write by multiplying by 1 by a times of minus cos x plus c. What is the integration of integral sin 5x? You know, this is nothing but sin 5x plus 0 dx. That means to say here you have a equals 5. Now look at, compare sin ax plus b, 5x plus 0. A is 5 and b is 0. So what is the answer? 1 by 5 into minus cos. And what is x? What should I have to write here? 1 by a times of minus cos of ax plus b. Because, you know, x has to be replaced by ax plus b. So, 1 by 5 minus cos of, how much is this? 5x. So, the answer is minus cos 5x by 5. Okay? I'll write one more, a few more examples. Integration of sin 6x plus 7 dx. Answer is minus 1 by 6. This minus sign comes from the formula here. Minus cos x minus cos of 6x plus 7. Plus c. Okay. What is integration of sin 3 by 2x dx? This is nothing but integral sin of, you know, the coefficient of x is 3 by 2 and there is no beta, so I just put it as 0. So if you observe, a is 3 by 2, and b is 0. So integration becomes 1 by a. How much is 3 by 2? I mean, how much is a? 3 by 2. So 1 by 3 by 2 into minus cos of ax plus b. That is 3 by 2 x plus 0. That is 2 by 3 along with the minus sign. So this minus and 1 by 3 by 2 is 2 by 3 into cos 3 by 2 x plus will be the answer. Okay? Fine. That's good. Now, for this integral, cos ax plus b into dx. You can give me the answer? Yes. It is 1 by a times of sin ax plus b. Now integrate some functions. Cos 3x dx, 1 by 3 sin 3x. Or you would simply say sin 3x by 3. Both are same. What is the integration of cos 10x plus root 3? This is a is how much? Ax plus b. A is 10. So 1 by 10 into cos 10x plus root 3 plus c. That's all. Okay? Now, the same thing even for this. Integral secant square x. So I write it as integral secant square ax plus b dx. This is 1 by a. Right hand side you multiply by 1 by a and it is tan of ax plus b. Yeah. Do some problems here. Integral secant square 10x dx. What is the answer? The answer is going to be 1 by a. A is 10. Here you observe that a is 10 and there is no beta. B is 0. So it is 1 by 10 times of tan of ax plus b. That is 10x plus b is 0. So it is tan 10x by 10. Okay. What is the integration of secant square 3x minus 2 dx? What is the value of a? A is 3, b is minus 2. So 1 by 3 tan 3x minus 2 plus c. That's going to be the answer. Very simple. Okay. Even for this, I replace x by ax plus c, ax plus b. So integral secant ax plus b into tan ax plus b dx. What should be the answer? Answer is 1 by a secant ax plus b. Thus the answer is secant x multiplied by 1 by a. Now do an example. Integral secant 5x into tan 5x dx. Answer is 1 by 5 secant 5x. Example 1. Take this example. Integral secant x minus 2 into tan x minus 2 dx. What is ax plus b here? A is 1, b is minus 2. So it is 1 by 1 into secant x minus 2. So the answer is just secant x minus 2 plus c. I hope you are following, right? That's good, that's good. Okay, the last one. I just have to now replace x by x plus b. Then integral e to the power of x dx becomes integral e to the power of ax plus b into dx. And the right hand side you have to multiply by 1 by a. So it is 1 by a times of e to the power of ax plus b. Because it is e to the power of x, x means ax plus b. Of course, plus c will be there. Now, take an example. Integral e to the power of 5x dx. 1 by 5, because this is ax plus b. B is 0 there. A is 5. So 1 by 5 into e to the power of 5x plus c. What is integration of A is how much? 1 here, and B is 0. So 1 by minus 1 into e to the power of minus x plus c, that is minus e to the power of minus x plus c. What is integration of e to the power of 3x plus 5? How much is a? Ax plus b, a is 3. So 1 by 3 into e to the power of 3x plus 5 plus c. So this is how we proceed with the integration. Whenever x is replaced with ax plus b, x is replaced with ax plus b, or 1x plus or ax plus 0, whatever be the case. If there is b term, retain that b term in the final answer also. If there is no b term, as you see here, then you will not have that b term, that's all. Here there is b term, fine. It is just retained in the answer. So the b is not going to create any type of problem. But only thing is that you should not forget to multiply the right hand side of these answers with 1 by a. And k should be taken to c to observe whether a is positive or negative. You know, there is a difference between 3 minus 4x and 4x minus 3. In 4x minus 3, a is 4, positive. In 3 minus 4x, a is negative, minus 4. Okay, so that, k should be taken while using this rule. Now, I want you to make this perfect so that we can start with the NCERT solutions, which contains, really very good problems on integration. Any learner, any student who wants to learn integration, I would strongly suggest to do all the problems from NCERT book. Now, these problems have been created, a lot of works, a lot of research have been done in creating these problems. Problems are really good in the NCERT book. Okay? So, you know, work out all the problems of all the exercises in the next classes to come. Before that, I want you to make this perfect.